The height from which the ball must be released to obtain the minimum critical velocity for completing the loop can be determined using the principle of conservation of energy. When the ball is initially placed on the track, it possesses gravitational potential energy, which is determined by the product of the ball's mass, gravitational acceleration, and the ball's vertical height. As the ball rolls down the incline, its velocity increases, and it gains kinetic energy according to the equation 1/2 m v squared. The increased kinetic energy comes at the expense of the decreased potential energy. At the bottom of the incline, all of the potential energy has left the ball and has been fully transformed into kinetic energy. As the ball continues to travel to the top of the loop, it slows down, giving up some kinetic energy and gaining back an equivalent amount of potential energy. For total energy to be conserved, the initial potential energy must equal the sum of the potential and kinetic energy present at the top of the loop. The starting height which the ball must be released from to give the minimum critical velocity of 1.4 meters per second can now be determined. Note that the ball's mass again cancels and plays no role in the calculation. Solving for the initial height and substituting values into the equation, a starting height of 0.50 meters is obtained. If the ball is released from a height less than 0.50 meters, it does not obtain the critical velocity and fails to complete the loop. Released from 0.50 meters, the ball is just able to round the top of the track and complete the loop.